This, my dear viewers, is maybe a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to listen to uncensored media for a few minutes. What I have to say is very important. I had to kill a lot of people, and I will get myself killed to get on your television.
I made the decision to value your interests higher than my life. I want to make you wake up and change. But before I tell you what I think you should do, I want to give you the facts. And I mean it, the facts. The NSA tapes every single phone call, email, and text on Earth. People like Snowden or Assange, who give us much-needed information to protect democracy, get hunted and prosecuted by the U.S. government. The U.S. government is funded by the rich and likes to keep people in the dark, ignorant, and on the brain level of children. They make sure people are busy, making money to survive, to take care of their family, their house, their lawn. They want people thinking they are free and have a choice and to do whatever they want, but they can't. The people that are representing you are bought and paid for to keep you stupid in your small, stupid little world. How can there be no gun control, even though there are monthly massacres? In the USA, 11,000 people are shot every year. In the UK, it's only 300. Why? Because the UK doesn't have guns. People don't have guns, period. What I've done in the past and what I'm doing right now is the result of no gun control. There aren't even background checks to filter out people with criminal records. Why is this? Because 50% of the senators and governors are paid by the gun industry. So wake up. Healthcare is of course beneficial for at least 95% of the people in America. Basically, all of the developed world has healthcare. Almost 50% of Americans are against it. Based on the perfect brainwashing media machine, the Iraq War was a crime. Powell, Bush, Cheney, and Rumsfeld lied to the United Nations and the rest of the world. Saddam had no weapons of mass destruction, and he had nothing to do with Al-Qaeda. But we know our friends, the Saudis, financed the 9/11 attacks. But because of their oil, we don't do anything against them. Instead, we send soldiers to die in countries that have nothing to do with domestic terror attacks. Why didn't Obama file charges against the Bush government? Bush cost the taxpayers hundreds of billions and committed war crimes. Why is Obama not doing anything about that? Because he is also paid and a member of the club. More migrants got deported under Obama than under any other president. Why didn't he close Guantanamo Bay, where prisoners sit without charges, evidence, proof, or a court case for over 13 years now? He did not veto the detainee provisions in the National Defense Authorization Act, which codify the indefinite detention of people, including Americans, without trial. We have a constitutional crisis in the United States. We now have a rogue state. It is a violation of international law, a violation of Magna Carta that goes back 800 years of what our sense of justice means. Obama should be charged for that, and he should go to jail. Speaking of jail, USA has 5% of the world's population and 25% of its world's prisoners. People go to jail because they have 10 grams of cocaine in their pockets. Half of the prisoners are in jail for drug possession, and more than half of them are black. Why does this absurd situation not get changed? I'll tell you why. Because Washington gets paid to keep it going by the prison industry lobby. Why don't the rich pop stars and film stars and white stockbrokers who use speed and cocaine and ecstasy every day get thrown in jail? Why? Because you are above the law. If you are rich, you watch Spielberg's Lincoln movie and you actually think the Civil War happened to free the slaves, so the billionaire Spielberg makes you even dumber. And they will make sure that that movie will be screened in schools and in TV nonstop forever. But the reality is that every war was about money, and the stupid people must die because the elite decided it. You sit in front of reality TV every day to kill your time, and you think you are up to date because you watch Anderson Cooper and other empty balloons without their own opinion. How you look doesn't matter. Brands don't matter. Drugs don't matter. This is all created to keep you stupid. The free press, TV, Hollywood movies, schools, universities, and religion are all opium for the masses, as Karl Marx would say. I want to make you
wake up and change.
I want you to change the world, and don't think that this is going to happen peacefully or you can do it alone. We need to kill the rich. You get out there, you use your weapons, and you rip Washington apart. You hunt down the billionaires, the bank bosses, the CEOs, the scumbags, and the liars, the governors, the lobbyists, the senators, because they're all the same, and you hang them from the first tree that you can find. We need a cleanse, people, okay? We need a reboot. We need to destroy that system. But I cannot do this work alone. I need you now. I need you now. We need to do this together.
Okay, so I thank you in advance for your help.
Thank you.